Okay, the next question that was asked is number 50. This is the last question on review assignment one, and it is asking us to sketch a graph. Now, you will not have to sketch a graph on the final, but you will have a lot of graphs that look like this, and you will have to take the graph and tell me this information. So sketching the graph is a good way to practice what all of this means. First of all, it tells us that f is continuous. I'm going to use this at the end. The first thing I'm going to do is put these limits on. Remember that a limit is the y value it appears the function is going to hit. We don't know from this if it's actually going to hit that value or not, so at each one of these points that's represented here, I'm going to put an open circle to begin with. So here is a point when x is negative 6, the y value appears to be 0. So at negative 6, I'm going to put an open point at 0. And because it doesn't have a little plus or minus after, I know that it comes in and out of negative 6, 0. The graph does. When x approaches negative 4 from below, the y value appears to be 2. So when I'm at negative 4, it looks like I'm heading into 2 when I come from below. When x approaches negative 4 from above, the y value appears to be positive infinity. So what that tells me is that there is really an asymptote at negative 4. It looks like I might have missed negative 4 slightly on my picture. There's really an asymptote at negative 4. And on this side, it looks like it's headed up toward positive infinity as we approach negative 4 from above. At negative 2, when x is negative 2, the y value appears to be 0. So at negative 2, I'm going to put a circle at the y value of 0, and I'm going to do from both sides, I'm going to draw little tails. The function is going to look like it goes in and out of that point. As x is approaching 0, the y value looks like negative 3. So here at 0, I'm going to go up to negative 3, put a circle, and again, there will be tails at both sides, in and out, because there's no little plus or minus. For 2, one more time, 2, 0, open circle, in and out, because there's no plus or minus. Aha, 4 from below looks like it's 1. So if I go over here to 4, I would have a y value appearing to be 1 if I'm approaching it from below. 4 from above, however, looks like it's negative 2. So if I go over to 4 and I'm coming at it from above, it looks like it's going to hit negative 2. And then 5 looks like it's going to hit 0 from both directions. Okay. The next thing I want to do is play connect the dots. This won't be the end because I'll still have to think about continuous. But it does say it's continuous from negative infinity all the way to negative 4. So I'm going to start here, and there's no rule about how I should draw this. I could come up from above, I could come down from below. Since I have almost no room, I'm just going to go straight like this, and then head up here and connect with that circle. Because it's continuous from negative infinity to negative 4, including negative 4, I'm going to make the decision that these can't have holes in it. It has to be connected, so I want to fill in those holes. So it's one continuous line there. Now from negative 4 to 4, it connects the whole way. So I'm going to come from this arrow, I'm going to come down and hit this supposed y value, leave that point, come up here and hit this y value, leave that, come down here and hit this one, come up, and now I've got to look for the tail. The tail's on this side, so that's what I'll connect to. And it says it's continuous, not including negative 4 or 4, but everything in between. So there cannot be a hole here. I'm going to fill that in. It cannot be a hole there, or it wouldn't be continuous. There cannot be a hole here. But this one says it's not continuous at 4 itself, so from below. So I'm leaving that one open. And then I'm going to connect from 4 to infinity. So this open circle should come up and hit this from below. I can't quite hit that tail well, but I just have to hit that y value, which is 0. And then I should leave that. I could go up, down. I have a lot of choices. I'll just continue on up. That'll work. And it's continuous including 4, so I'm going to fill this one in. And there shouldn't be a hole here because it's continuous this whole way. It doesn't have to be wiggly here. We could just have it go straight like that through 6, 0. So, wow, it's really thick there. But so it's hitting 6, 0 and on through. Continuous from negative infinity to negative 4. Continuous open from negative 4 to 4. And then continuous from 4 to infinity. Okay. And what you need to be able to do is if I give you this graph and I say, what is the limit as x approaches 2, then you need to be able to go over here to 2 and say, aha, it looks like the y value I'm hitting is 0. You need to know that when it says this, you look for y values. And that's that's the end of that problem. Thank you.